Hi, I'm Dr. Daniel Kantor, president of the Florida Society of Neurology. And some of you at MS World may also know that I'm on the healthcare advisory panel of the MS Foundation, or MSF. What happens in a meeting like this one, like the Consortium of MS Centers, is that we get to go around to different exhibits and we get to meet people from different nonprofits. And we're so lucky to be here and joined by the two co-directors of the MS Foundation. So we're joined here by Jules and Alan. And what I want to know, and what the people back home want to know, is when should they call the MSF? How should they communicate with the MSF? And how can the MS Foundation fit into their lives with their MS?
Well, I'll tell you how they can contact us. www.msfocus.org, 800-225-6495. We have dedicated caseworkers who are there to help and make a difference in anyone's life that's impacted by multiple sclerosis.
So what do you think some of the big things that MSF does throughout the year for people with MS? Some of us have heard about this thing called the Cruise for a Cause. Tell us a little bit more about it, Alan.
Well, the Cruise for the Cause is going into its 13th year. And initially it started off as strictly a patient education program. But then what we noticed after a couple of cruises, it was more than just education. We use the acronym, it's all about me, motivating, educating, empowering. We found people were coming on and they were getting empowered to do things that they have never done or haven't done in years. And then they took this back with them when they went home and basically came up with a better quality of life because they felt that they had something positive in their life now.
So the cruise is coming up pretty soon, right? It's coming up in June, and I'll be joining you guys, and we'll actually be doing videos. And actually, it's going to be a little bit of a reverse. We're going to be doing videos with MS Foundation, and we're going to be sharing them with MS World, just like MS World shares the videos with MS Foundation. So we think that's a good connection.
That's fantastic.
Can you tell us a little bit more about also the Cooling Program and the Brighter Tomorrow grants? Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Certainly. The Brighter Tomorrow grant was really a takeoff from Make-A-Wish. And what we did is we have a program that it's a secular program. It's applications open September through November 1st. And a person writes in 300 words or less what would make them have a brighter tomorrow. And we've had people, one of the things that I remember, there was a young lady, her name was Jane Calder, I think it is, and she had a manual pottery wheel, and she did manual pottery, but with her MS, she found it was difficult to use her feet to run her pottery wheel, so we got an electric pottery wheel. So it's stories like that. It's just items that you wouldn't ordinarily get from your own self, you wouldn't be able to afford to get. The maximum is $1,000 per item. That's the max we go.
And Jules, we know that MS Foundation, the corporate headquarters are in Fort Lauderdale, but who gets the services of the MS Foundation?
Inasmuch as we're located in Fort Lauderdale, those services are nationally accessible. They're made available to people in all 50 states. As a matter of fact, some of our publications are read by people in 82 countries. But we're there basically to help people in the United States who are living with multiple sclerosis make it to that next level. We solve problems.
Well, guys, I want to thank you so much for joining us. I want to thank you so much for all the motivating, empowering, and educating, because as we all know, it's all about me.
You bet.
So thank you for joining us.
Thank you.